storyteller, entrepreneur, and a motivational speaker. He is also a public speaker and runs his PSA, Public Speaking Academy. He started e-reading Shalom. Happy Holidays Medley is his first paperback. Arne, can you... am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yes. Arne, so take it from here.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So, hello, everyone. Thank you for inviting me. Hope you all are having a nice day. So, let me just tell you about myself. My name is Arne Agarwal. I am in 7th grade. I like reading books. I like reading books a lot. As you can see by the library I have here. And I find writing as a fun activity. So, writing and reading is quite similar. So, before that, let me just tell you about some things that I do. So, I love to work on initiatives for children. My first initiative was STS India, Storytelling Society of India, in which I basically teach the children how to do storytelling and how to basically teach them storytelling. And I also run a public speaking academy, as ma'am said, in which I tell them public speaking, how to do public speaking, and I help them to improve in that. I have also started e-reading Shala. It's basically just a book club in its simplest form. It's a book club of many children in which I bring out books. I bring out books and sometimes other children also read their own books. And basically it helps to encourage many children to read. I also am an author and a writer. I like to write books. I've written three books so far and I'm working on my fourth one. The first one is Juno and Ira. It's basically just a story about two kids who are near a jungle and they have many adventures. And I'm sure many of you also write, right? Do you? I'm sure you do. And I find ma'am, you were just teaching them, and then I really like when children write together, they write stories together, and that just makes me quite happy, because I like writing, and I like to write with other people too. My second book was Raffle and Binny, and my third book, my most recent book is Happy Holiday Medley. So it's basically last vacation. I didn't go out of Bangalore to celebrate my holidays, my summer vacation. I just stayed in Bangalore, and I just thought that if I stay in Bangalore, what can I do? I can literally do nothing, right? But I was proved wrong. There are so many things I could do, and it's like I rediscovered Bangalore. So, and then there's my fourth book, which I'm writing right now, and I really am enjoying writing it. It's going to be a novel. I never thought I'll write a novel in my life, but it's happening right now. I'm writing a novel, and it's basically about a teacher who has her whole life turned upside down and then goes on adventures. So now I'll tell you all about reading, okay? So I found out that many children don't enjoy reading, right? Like many children, I've heard, enjoy playing games. I have few friends who I bring a book to their house to read, and the whole time I can't even touch the book because either my friend's playing on laptop or either he's watching TV and all that. I just feel like nobody really reads. So what I have thought is that reading should be a daily habit and books should be your best friend. Because when I was little, my mom brought me lots of books with a lot of bright pictures. Lot of fun activities in the book. And I started to read them little by little. And then soon I started to enjoy books. And books, they transport you to different worlds. Like, Have you ever read a book about something and then you get completely lost in it? You get completely lost in it and you don't even know what's happening in the real world. You're just in the imaginary world. If some of you have read Chronicles of Narnia, it has so much imagination. You can just imagine that you are the children and you're going into the winter wonderland. And that's the power of books. They can just take you anywhere. And they can help you understand difficult concepts and like complex concepts easily. Example, if you perhaps have a book, have textbooks about some kind of subject like biology or something, about the heart or something, many of you will find it boring. But if you're a person that enjoys reading books, then you'll just find it so easy. You'll just find it interesting to read about. And that's the power of books. They are so powerful that they are your best friends, don't you think? Books are your best friends. When you get bored, when you're bored and you don't want to do anything, when you're sad, what do? You just take up a book about something that makes you happy and start reading it. And that is so much enjoyable. So that is why I say reading should be a daily habit for you all. You should just read a little bit of a book every day, and that will just be so fun. It's honestly not even, you can't call reading any work. Reading is in its simplest form an exciting activity, right? What else is it? It's just a fun activity that people can do. So I would encourage all of you to make reading a daily habit of you and ensure that you read every day and every single day. And so now I have heard many people asking me, how did you get inspired? How have you gotten inspired to write your first book? Well, I have always been a child of imagination. So basically, I had so much imagination. I used to be lost in it always. I used to be lost while playing with my friends. I used to be lost while eating. I used to be lost while taking a bath. I always used to be lost in my imagination. And this was really frustrating for my mom because it gave her a hard time. Because one day, I'll just tell you an incident. One day, I was eating normal lunch, roti paratha. Roti and curry, and my mom hadn't served the curry yet, so I took a piece of the roti and I was lost in my imagination during that time. I took a piece of my roti and the place where my mom would put the curry, I put the roti in there, but there was no curry. So I was just imagining that there was curry and I was eating it, and I didn't even notice that there was no curry. I just, you know how you do the action of taking the curry in the bite? I just did that over and over again without realizing there was no curry. So my mom couldn't understand. What was I doing? Why was I just so lost? Was I absent-minded? But then when she understood that I had so much imagination and I used to always be thinking about something or the other thing, she told me, if you really have so much thinking, just write it down somewhere. Don't just always be lost in it. Please write it down somewhere. And that's how it started. I started to write books of fiction, of adventures, and so many amazing things. And that's how I started to write. And during that time, I also like to read a lot of books. And reading, if you read, writing will be so easy for you. One of the most hardest parts is to think of an idea and keep it going. Like when you think of idea, maybe an old woman who is being chased by some people. You get the idea, but you don't know how to continue it. But if you read books, you get an idea of how storytelling works, how stories work. And then it really helps you to write stories.
You have already spoken so well, so elaborately about story writing, Arne. Have you also ventured into writing poems?
Writing poems?
Yes.
Yeah, I've written a poem about my grandmother.
Okay.
I don't have it right now, but
okay, no problem. No problem.
He was like, I love my grandmother. I didn't write grandmother, I wrote Nani, because that's what I call her. And I also call her. So yeah, I have written some poems too.
So how much time do you normally devote to writing a story from the beginning till putting in the final edits and actually making it into a complete story? You must be putting in a draft first and then coming back to it again after some time. How do you do that?
First, during school, and I've written most of my books every day, a little, little bit every day.
Okay.
So after school, I come back. Now that I have online school, it's much easier to write books because I have a lot of time. So I just come back from school and then I write a little bit, maybe 5 sentences, or on days which I'm really tired, I just write 2 sentences. It's just that I write every single day. I don't stop writing at all. I just write every single day, and that helps me to continue the story.
And have you ever felt like, supposing you have completed a story and you actually thought your story was done, but then maybe when you came back to your story after a few months or maybe a couple of weeks, you thought you might like to change the story here and there, in little bits here and there?
Yeah, so that's
some edits, some changes.
That was actually the case in one of my stories. It was it's not a published book. It was published in many newspapers. It was Chuck the Chicken. It was Chuck the Chick. So it was basically a story about a little chick called Chuck. And I finished it. And then a few days later, I saw it and I thought maybe I can use some good grammar, change the words up a little bit. And then a few weeks later, I come back. I decide to change it a little bit, and I wrote more than half the story again.
You can just raise your hand. Anyone wants to ask Arne anything? Vihan wants to ask something? Who wants to ask Arne something about story writing, about publishing? So where have you published your stories, Arne?
So I have published Juno and Ira, my first story on Juggernaut. I published it on Juggernaut.
That's great.
Juggernaut is pretty easy to publish on. It's basically helps you publish your own stories. It's a self-publishing platform. You can just do it yourself. And
it is like Amazon's Kindle Direct publishing.
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, kind of.
And then my Happy Holiday Medley, that book I have published on Amazon. I have actually, I have it, I have a paperback and an ebook. So as
okay, that's great.
Yeah, so the ebook you can just get for 50 rupees for today. I just decided, it's usually at 200 rupees, but I just kept it for 50 rupees for today. And the paperback is right here, you can also buy it.
Can you please bring the book closer to your camera so that all of us can see?
Yes, ma'am, can you see it?
Okay, I think Anushka has a question.
Yes, so like I have very recently started doodling and editing. So when I make comic strips and when I have to make illustrations and everything, I need to have a background story for it, right? Because drawing anything in doodling is like a lot of thing without any story. So it's useless, right? So how do you get these short and sweet prompts so easily? Like, you know, because most of my time then goes into thinking about the plot, story and everything. And then I really can't devote equal amount of time in making my artwork.
So basically, I mean, you take a lot of time in thinking about the plot and the story.
Yes,
Before you even start on the story, you spend a lot of time thinking about it.
Yes, so I can't really work on the main thing, which is creating the illustration.
Okay, so basically what you can do is you can start your story. You always have an idea, so you start it. You can always start it easily, like you started something like give a prompt can be, I'll take an example from you. from your prompts, ma'am. You just gave one. Can anybody supply me with a prompt?
Sorry?
Can anybody give me a prompt?
Okay, can I only give one?
Of course, Anushka, yes.
So then there is this person, social worker. She has gone to some place and she wants to buy a souvenir for herself and her fellow people. Now the prompt was, I reached to the hospital somehow. So then she goes there, but then she misses out on the direction and lands up in a vicinity where there is a hospital.
Okay.
So there is no bloodshed or accident or anything as such. She just happens to reach there by mistake.
Okay, that is a prompt. You have a character and you have almost a backdrop. But you can add to that backdrop.
Yeah. So you can basically just start. You can start the writing about it. You can, if when you get a background, you will have to think a little bit. So you have to just get the background. Like the lady wants to get a souvenir for her fellow workers. So you get the starting. She sees her fellow workers are little sad because they have to work very hard. So she decides to bring souvenirs. So that can be the starting. So that after you start, you don't have to make up everything before. You have to start writing, and whatever ideas come into your mind, you can just put them down. You can take the story anywhere in the first draft, and then after you're done with the story, it doesn't need to be the perfect story in the start. After you're done with the story for the first draft, you can just see, look over it, and then you get a general idea of what the story is about, what direction you want to go. And then after that, you can just change it little by little every day. And then slowly you will understand, like, okay, so this part should be there and this part shouldn't be there. Okay?
Yes, thank you, ma'am. My question was, when we are writing the draft and it is finished, so when will we know when that it is ready to show that this is finished, when it is ready to, like, publish? How did you know, like, it was ready?
So,
you will be the best person to know, Kalish.
Yeah. When you are satisfied with your own story and when you like your own story, then it is ready to publish.
Absolutely. Yes.
And also, if you take some feedback from, your friends, your parents, anyone close, maybe your teacher, maybe your English teacher can take some advice from her or him.
And then we have Ivy also with a doubt. Ivy?
Okay, so it's pretty easy for us to make up stories in our mind, but how to execute? Most of the authors and writers have this problem of executing the executing your story you've made up in your mind. So, how to do that?
So, first, like, if you have a lot of ideas, if you have like an idea, you should write it down. Like, whatever you have in your mind, you can write it down.
Yes, we discussed jotting down. We discussed putting notes. Remember yesterday we discussed putting notes. Yes, Arnay, this is exactly it. Right.
And after that, if you know how to structure a story, you can start structuring your ideas in a story, like a plot, a beginning, an ending, rising action, falling action. You can do all that. And then you can also, what you said, read some books and get some ideas from them, how a story is structured, how it goes, what is the flow. And then you can apply those principles to your own book, to your own ideas.
Okay, I think we have Vihan wanting to ask something. Vihan? I saw Vihan raising his hand.
Do we need to be an artist to design the hardcover of a book?
What? Can you repeat that?
Do we need to be an artist to design the book cover?
So after you have written the book, you can decide what you want. Either you can make it yourself. I mean, here you can see. So these are basically in my book. These are all the pictures from my different like places I went in Bangalore. So the one is Halloween, one is my zoo adventure, one is my photography thing. So all of those pictures, I took a picture and put them in a collage. And then after that, I put a title, I put a little subtitle, and then I put my name in the bottom. You can do that. If you can take your parents' help, and then you can create a cover that you like, or you can go to a publisher and then tell them that you need to make a cover, and they can also help you. So there's two options that you can do. Either you can make it yourself. You don't need to be a very special artist. Maybe you have like you read your story, and if it's about a giant monster, you can just draw a little bit of a monster. Many people like doodling, right? So maybe you can put some of your doodles on the cover page in a collage. So that's the thing. You can either make it yourself, or you can make it using somebody else's help, like somebody hired. You can hire somebody.
Thank you.
Thank you, Arne. Any more questions we have, Arne? Otherwise, for Arne, because otherwise we have another guest waiting, I think, Richa.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Do you have any more questions for Arne?
Ma'am, I have one. Can I ask?
Yes, of course, Manraj, for Arne.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So, like the first book you have written, so did this story come in your mind, or you have observed anything in your surrounding that made you write the story?
So I got an idea. I mean, I got an idea from reading some books, and I got an idea from my imagination that maybe I can have some adventures, maybe some kind of lonely place. So actually, the name of Juno and Ira's village where they live, I searched it on the globe. I have a globe with me. I just searched a random place that I could find, which was quite remote, and then I just put that as the name. And in the story, there are some elements that I observed. Like, I went on a car trip, and there was this kind of a scary jungle where there was almost no light and nobody, which was quite an interesting incident. So
So
that's
eventually, that is his surrounding. That is what he had observed. The car trip, no light, the jungles, that was what he observed. This was his surrounding. Yes or no? Right.
So I took my surroundings, I took some of my ideas from some books and imagination, and I put them down, and I got a story. That's basically how I started to write Juno and Ira. Okay.
That was wonderful interacting with you, Arne, and the confidence with which you were speaking and the confidence with which you were taking up questions is so matured, it's so professional, and I really say hats off to you. And may you have many more feathers coming to your hat, and may you keep writing more. I would like to read your book someday. And so congratulations once again from all of us here to
Thank you,
Arne.
ma'am.
Thank you
Thank
so
you
very
so
much,
much.
Arne.
Thank
It
you
was
so much
wonderful. I am going back enriched today. So,
Thank
Richa, we have some more?
you. Yes, ma'am. So I
Yes,
would like to take
please.
it from here now.
Thank
Yes,
you. Thank you,
but
everyone.
Arne, I think please don't leave us, because towards the end we will have once more. Manraj, we would request you once more to recite your poem for all of us here, because some had missed up because they came in late. So please sit back, Arne, and be our guest.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Arne. Yes, Richard.
Okay. So now I would like to welcome Dr. Nirmala Krishnan for an interaction. Dr. Nirmala Krishnan, a woman who inspires millions. Growing up across India as a daughter of defense personnel, she completed her graduation in pharmacy and switched to education as her career. Humble beginning from kindergarten teacher to principal of renowned Mahindra World School and country head education for the Jindal.